You see that this hatchery is almost done. This is almost completely mined out. His natural expansion is still doing pretty well. Not that good on the saturation, but we do have purple moving in. This might be a better idea. We got all the stalkers on the front. We got three colossi up here. And just look at the damage that they're doing to these guys. We got the second stalker coming out. We've got a couple of zealots up here. They're not really sure what they're doing. But this colossi is almost about to go down. That one goes down. These stalkers are still up. So it looks like the hydras were focus firing. And all of those hydras are dead. Look at that. Massive damage. Now, ambient has the upper hand just slightly. But as you can see, dead zone is actually pulling up, rematching the units, but they're in a perfect place. This nice little choke right there, as you can see, dead zone running away from these stalkers. Nice place for ambient to hit with the with this colossus. They won't be able to get a nice concave. These zerg units won't be able to get a nice concave, but would have been able to take good advantage of the extended thermal lance, but probably just not something that many hydralisks with. With all these stalkers, not something that he wants right now. But now he's got two colossi coming in. He's got another one. Do we have any upgrades going? No. 1-2-1-1-1. We have got no upgrades going. Looks like these gateways are still locked down, so he doesn't have anything over here. Let's do a quick check over on this side, see what we got going on. Do we have any more tech advancements? We still have this natural up here, so the double natural behind the rocks. Hasn't been broken into. I think Dead Zone might be saving that in case one of these other guys runs out and he has to backtrack into that, which actually might be a good idea. Ambient warping in a couple more units. There we go. A couple more zealots. Let's look at the tech back here again, see what's going on. Nothing. Almost completely mined out over there. So Ambient's got to be thinking to go in again. He's trying to pull this Zerg player, pull Dead Zone over here into the ideal attack area for Ambient so that he can get some good damage going. But he can sneak up over here and really take advantage of them being choked off over there. We do have an Overseer coming out of the cocoon. So what do we have over here? We do have the layer up. We might... don't think we're going to see Mutilus at all. And we have 1-1-1-2, so we've got two missile attack going up. So the Hydras are upgraded just a little bit. These Colossi taking care of those Hydras. Looks like they were might have been auto-routed to come down here. And let's see what's going on. Going to get some nice quick view of what's going on over there. Maybe got to get these zealots out in front, though. Once you get the zealots out in front, nice little meat shield. Not when you're up there, though. You can take out a couple of zerglings with the colossi. And look at that range, the hydralisks. Barely able to reach them. I don't know how they could see up there. Maybe the massive unit thing, I don't know. But the hydralisks were able to see up there. And do a little bit of damage to one of these colossi, but not enough to even take him out of the shields. And as you can see, Ambient just, he has the more dominant army now. And he's just going to slowly make his way. Looks like he's going to go for the back door or check for the gold expansion, see what's going on over here. But as you can see, we've got some Hydra sneaking in over here. Probe's going to see that. These pylons are going to see that, so this army is going to come back over here. Very bad position for Dead Zone right there. See how he's in that nice little corner right there? And these colossi are just going to be able to knock these guys down, especially with the zealots coming up front, unless Dead Zone can focus fire on something, and it looks like he's not focus firing on anything. As they were taken down, burnt to a crisp. I hope you like your Zerg with barbecue sauce. Because almost that entire group was taken down. A couple speedlings in the back, but you got the zealots. Zealots do have charge, so it's evened out just a little bit back there. But they're just going to run over here. The colossus will turn around, nuke those speedlings, and just look at this. It is time to cause some serious damage. We have all these stalkers. 1, 2, 3, 5 colossi. Let's see if we got anybody else coming out. We've got 21 hydrolisks, although they're all scattered. We've got the six that are going to come out over here. It looks like these colossi might be able to take these down before they even pop out. We've got the six over here, nope, six, three, and none up there. And looks like Dead Zone is finally moving up there. 2,500 in resources left over, so he's lacking the army. And as you can see, Ambient has absolutely nothing less. He's completely gas heavy. But looking at that, sentries throw up a couple of shields, reducing that damage that the Hydralis are doing, and he is just slowly storming into this base with the five colossi. He actually has, does he have any more units coming up? Is he developing any more? These probes aren't doing anything. We've got more units coming up on this side, two colossi coming up, and these guys are just taken out. There goes the Roach Warren. That's going to go down. Popped. The evolution chamber's going to disappear. These the broodlings are going down. Anybody left doing minerals, and Dead Zone calls a good game. So with the some really nice positioning, especially with the splash damage taken by the colossi and those nice little choke points all over the place, Ambient was able to take advantage and defeat Dead Zone, even though Dead Zone was at a two base advantage. And that was game one between the two. Like I said, Ambient took this game, and Ambient took game one, and we'll be waiting to see what happens in game two. This is Droggoth checking out.